Hello, in this video we will build an USB Power Delivery dual role application using the Xcube TCPP software pack. First, we will introduce the software pack and its capabilities. After, we will list the requirements to build the following projects. Then, we will install the software pack. And we will start with the first project using the Xnucleo DRP1M1 expansion board. Finally, we will show how to build a project based on your own custom board. The Xcube TCPP software pack is dedicated to build USB power delivery applications in sync, source or dual role mode in standard power range when the hardware is based on a STM32 MCU with a UCPD peripheral and with a TCPP product interfacing this MCU to the USB Type-C connector. Using this pack, there is no need to write any line of code and no need for a deep knowledge of the USB Type-C standard. The software pack can help for two hardware configurations. The first consists of a Nucleo and the Xnucleo dedicated to the application to build. The second is a custom board with a STM32 MCU embedding the UCPD peripheral and the TCPP product related to the application. Finally, the software pack documentation is available in the Xcube TCPP pack in its documentation folder and is also accessible from KubeMX in the software pack section. Requirements. At the software point of view, we will need STM32 CubeMX at least release 6.11.0, the Xcube TCPP software pack at least release 4.1.0, an IDE such as STM32 Cube IDE, and for debug, STM32 Cube Monitor UCPD. These software are available on ST.com. At the hardware level, for a project based on an expansion board, we will need the Xnucleo DRP1M1 and a compatible Nucleo 64, so from series G0 or G4, or a custom board. We will also need a sync and a source device for debug. It can be real devices like a Bluetooth speaker and a charger, or our solutions made of a Nucleo G0 or G4 and the Xnucleo SNK1M1 or Xnucleo SRC1M1 and corresponding firmware. Software pack installation. Open STM32 CubeMX. In the software pack area, click on the Install Remove button. Select the ST Microelectronics tab. Scroll down to reach the Xcube TCPP software pack. And if it is not already installed, click on the Install button. Then click on Close. Project with an expansion board. In CubeMX, in the File menu, click on New Project. Select the Board Selector tab and type your Nucleo reference. In my case, Nucleo G071RB. Select it and click on Start Project. Click on Yes. Again, in the File menu, click on Save Project As. Click right to create a new folder. I name it DRP1M1. Click on Save. Then, in the Pinout menu, click on Clear Pinouts, click on Yes. In the Software Pack menu, click on Select Components. Scroll down to reach the Xcube TCPP Software Pack. Select the dual role application and the board support for Xnucleo DRP1M1. There are some warnings. Click on the warning in front of the application for details. First, the application needs the board part for TCP/IP 0203. Just enable it. Back to the warnings. The application needs the USB power delivery middleware. Click on OK. In the middleware and software pack category, the USB PD middleware cannot be selected because it needs an instance of the UCPD peripheral. So in the connectivity category, select UCPD1 and enable it in dual role mode. Enable its interrupt and its DMA TX on channel 2 and DMA RX on channel 4, for example. You can choose any DMA channel except DMA channel 1, which is used by the software pack for ADCs. Now let's go back to the USB PD middleware and enable it for this peripheral. As the application is a DRP, in the stack port parameters, enable the CAD role toggle. Now, in the PDO, Power Data Object, General Definition, we keep the 5V PDO for sync and for source, but you have the possibility to add PDOs depending on your board in the USB Power Delivery Standard Power Range, so up to 100 watts. These two following tables, extracted from the USB Power Delivery Standard, explain how to calculate PDO for a source PDO value, for a sync PDO value. Back to the software pack. The next warning is due to the need of an RTOS. The software pack is ready for FreeRTOS and Azure RTOS. Click on OK. In the middleware and software pack category, click on FreeRTOS and enable it in CMC's V1 mode and increase its total heap size to 7000 bytes. Back again to the software pack, there is still a warning, which is due to the BSP, because it needs HAL drivers for ADC and I2C. Click on OK. In the connectivity category, select an I2C and enable it. And same thing for ADC in the analog category. Just enable one channel of ADC. No need to do the configuration as it will be done by the software pack. Let's check the software pack. There are no more warnings. Click on OK. In the middleware and software pack category, scroll down to reach the XQTCPP software pack and enable the application, the board part, and the board support. In the clock configuration menu, set the clock in PLL mode in order to set its maximum. Then, in the project manager menu, select your IDE, in my case STM32CubeIDE, increase the minimum heap size to C00, no change for the code generator, and in the advanced settings, remove the code generation for ADC and I2C as it will be done by the software pack. Right now, it's possible to generate the code, but for debug purpose, we'll enable the tracer and GUI interface. In the utilities section, the tracer and GUI cannot be selected because it needs an UART. So in the connectivity section, let's enable LPUART1 in asynchronous mode. With interrupt, NDMA TX on channel 3, and let's increase the baud rate to 921,600 bauds. As the Nucleo Virtual COM port is connected to PA2 and PA3. Remap its pin with a left click. Now, in the Utilities category, enable the tracer with LPU ART1. In the middleware, select USB PD as tracer source. And back to the Utilities, enable the GUI interface. Set a hardware name, for example Nucleo G071, and a type name, for example DRP1M1. The configuration is completed. Let's generate the code. Click on Yes. Click on Open Project. CubeIDE has started and imported the project. Let's develop it. In the application core, you will find the main. In TCPP, you will find the application startup. In USB PD, our sources where the software pack wrote code specific to this dual role device. And if you open USB PD DPM user, then USB PDO devs. This file contains PDO definitions with the source number, the sync number, and tables for PDO sources and here for PDO sync. In driver BSP, you will find the component part and the board support package. And in the middleware, FreeRTOS and the USB PD middleware. Now let's build the project. No error, no warnings. And as I have this board connected to my computer, I can start the debug. This is OK. Now I start the STM32 Cube Monitor UCPD. I select the board, then the port, and I start the measurement. Here you can see that the application is toggling looking for sync or for source. So let's connect a source device. Here you can observe the steps of negotiation. Here, VBIOS voltage and current. Now, I disconnect the source and connect a sync. Again, the negotiation and the current and voltage monitoring. Project with a custom board. In CubeMX, in the file menu, click on New Project. In the MCU selector tab, in the commercial part number, type your MCU reference. In my case, it will be STM32 G474RE in order to change from previous example. Click on it and click on Start Project. Again, in the file menu, click on Save Project As. Click right to create a new folder and name it DRP. Click on Save. Then, in the software pack menu, click on Select Components. Scroll down to reach the Xcube TCPP software pack. Enable the dual role application and the board part for TCPP 0203. There are some warnings. Click on the warning in front of the application for details. The application needs the USB PD middleware and an RTOS. Click on OK. Here I will go faster as we have already done it in the previous example. First, in the middleware and software pack category, The USB PD middleware cannot be selected because it needs an instance of the UCPD peripheral. So in the connectivity section, let's enable UCPD1 in dual role mode. Enable its interrupt and its DMA TX on channel 2 and DMA RX on channel 4, for example. Then enable the USB PD middleware. Default 5V PDO source and sync are OK for this example. But in the PDO general definition, you can increase the number of source PDO and number of sync PDO and define their values in the PDO source tab and PDO sync tab. For the RTOs, enable free RTOs in CMC's V1 mode and increase its IP size to 7000 bytes. Let's check the software pack. No more warning. Click on OK. So back in the middleware and software pack category, select the XKubeTCPP software pack and enable the application and the board port. There are some warnings in the platform settings. We have to assign resources you have affected on your custom board for each requirement. NADC, NI2C, an external internet input, and a GPIO output. So first, the ADC for VBUS. So in the analog section, select your ADC and its channel. In my case, ADC1, channel 1, in single-ended mode. Adjust your clock prescaler. Keep 12-bit resolution. Enable the continuous conversion mode. And set the sampling time to a medium value. Now, let's configure the I2C for the TCPP bus. In my case, I2C1. And adjust it in fast mode. Then select an external interrupt input, in my case PC5. And in the GPIO category, configure it with falling edge detection with pull-up. Then select a GPIO output, in my case PC8. Then in the software pack, in the platform settings, assign these resources to the application requirements. Then, in the clock configuration menu, set it in PLL mode in order to set its maximum. And in the project manager menu, select your IDE, in my case, STM32Cube IDE. Increase the minimum IP size to C00. No change for the code generator, no change in the advanced settings. Now it's possible to generate the code. Click on Yes. And on Open Project. CubeIDE started and imported the project. Let's develop it and build it. No error, no warnings. You can debug it on your custom board. To go further, you can refer to the software pack documentation included in the pack itself and also accessible through CubeMX. It also exists tutorial videos like this one explaining step by step how to create a sync or a source application. And finally, You can refer to the XQTCPP page on st.com for further information. Thank you.